of my true love's hair. Her lips are like some roses, babe. She's got the sweetest smile and gentlest hands, and I love her.
Kimberly, will you have this man to be your husband? To live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Eric, you have this woman to be your wife, live together in the covenant of marriage. You love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live. Now, will all of you, witnessing these promises, all in your power to uphold these two persons in their marriage?
We will.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking your blessing. Assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make through Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
From the Song of Solomon, set me as a seal upon thine heart, as a seal upon thine arm, for love is strong as death, jealousy is cruel as grief. I'll start it with the long song. My love, my beloved spake, and said unto me, rise up, my love, my fair one, and come away. For lo, the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of the singing of the birds has come, and the voice of the turtle is heard in our land. The fig tree put its forth her green figs, and the vines with the tender grape give a good smell. Arise, my love, my fair one, come away. Set me as a seal upon thy heart, a seal upon thy arm, for thy love is strong as death, jealousy is cruel as the grave. The coals thereof are coals of fire, which hath a most vehement flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can the flood drown it. If a man would give all the substance of his house to love, he would be utterly condemned.
Please stand. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
Jesus said, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. Keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. For those of you who are not necessarily a part of this very blessed ceremony and this marriage this morning, what I need to say to you is that Kimberly is part of our Diocese of Washington staff. And so for me to be the Bishop of Washington, to be a part of Eric and Kim's wedding today, is a great honor. Lest anybody misunderstand, it has been raining for many days. And yet, the power of God's love and the relationships of love that have brought Eric and Kim together today, their love has bound us together weather that is emerging as wonderful. You don't want to hear much more from me, except in the time in which this wedding would have taken place, people of the time believed in the power of miracles. Those of you who have a relationship with another, or have been married or partnered with another, that you can understand maybe even just a little bit about the miracle of love that brings new people together. So today, we share in that miracle that has brought Eric and Kim together. And we give thanks to God for that miracle. And so for the rest of the day, as you celebrate, remember one thing. Consciously, remember the gift of God's miracle in each of our lives. Sometimes, as challenging as our lives are, God is always present. And when you forget that, look at your partner, your best friend, your wife, your spouse. The power of God's love, the miracle of it, will not fade away. Amen. And of the Holy Spirit. Bless, O Lord, be great. The assigned vows by which Eric and Kimberly have bound themselves to be killed through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow, and with all that I am, and love.
that Kimberly and Eric have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands, and the giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, that no one can sever. Amen. Now let us pray together in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made, and for which your Son gave his life, and especially upon Eric and Kimberly, whom you make one flesh and holy matrimony. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength and need, a counselor in perplexity, comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Give them grace when they hurt each other, recognize and acknowledge their fault, and seek each other's forgiveness and help. Bestow upon them, if it is your will, the gift parents and children, and the grace to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you. Grant that all married persons who have witnessed these vows may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. Amen. God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it represents the spiritual unity between Christ and his church. Set therefore your blessing on these your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and through godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now, may God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you, fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this age, and in the age to come, may God grant you the gift of life and life. Amen.
Hey!